I'm Ed Gillis. I'm the CEO for Revolution Contraceptives. I've worked for 30 years in the medical device industry, and my dad actually worked in the medical device industry as well before me. And I came out of graduate school in Massachusetts, moved to California, and I have worked from large companies to small companies. And the last three or four companies I worked in, in a couple cases, it was just me starting out and trying to develop a new product and bring it to market, something that would help patients. So at Revolution Contraceptives, we're working on a reversible form of male contraception. So it's a procedure that the patient will undergo. It's, in our case, similar to a non-scalpel vasectomy. So it's very simple procedure that a urologist or a someone who works in a fertility clinic, perhaps, or general practitioner could do. The way the procedure works is they access the vas deferens, which is the conduit that carries sperm from the testes on out of the body. And what we do is we access that vessel in a very similar procedure, simple procedure. We then inject a small amount of liquid into the vessel, and the liquid converts over to a gel. And that gel has some very unique properties. First of all, it makes a great block to the vessel, and it effectively, at least in the studies that we have done, it effectively blocks sperm. It does so, though, while allowing some fluids to make it through. So we're hopeful, and only the data will tell us, that we'll have something that will be an effective contraception product for men, but will also perhaps produce fewer side effects than might be observed in a vasectomy. And when I say fewer side effects, those that might be related to pressure that forms in the vessel when you snip and clip off the ends, which is typical of a vasectomy procedure. We think our procedure will be much simpler to reverse. You know, right now, if you look at vasectomy procedures that get done, only 3 to 5% of people that do vasectomies can actually reverse a vasectomy. So it makes it hard on the patient who has a procedure done and maybe has a situation that changes, and his family, he decides he wants a family with his partner. And instead of having to seek out one of the 3 or 5% of physicians that do it and undergo a several hour microsurgery procedure, we have a procedure that we think will be no more difficult than what it took to put it in, that every person who does the procedure can do. There's two things we need. We need good people who are dedicated and who have expertise in their area, whether that area be engineering and design, whether it be managing regulatory affairs for the company, whether it be ensuring that the product is of high quality, or whether it be ensuring that we can convince investors to put money into the company or manage the administration of the company. We need good people that are dedicated to what we're doing and are willing to commit themselves to it. And the second thing we need is we need money. And the money in some ways can help attract the people, but my experience is people are attracted to ideas typically, and to making a difference in the world. And I can't think of a more meaningful way to make a difference in the world than to limit the amount of unintended pregnancies. You can get excited about the mission and what we'll ultimately do 10 years from now, but the reality is I need to do something today that makes progress towards getting there. And those things today are maybe not the most glamorous things you can do. It might be sitting on a lab bench, working with the material, showing how it performs. But I'll tell you, the one thing that excites me the most is every time I work with our product and see what it can do, I just believe more and more that it can work. We want to thank MCI for their dedication to the cause that we believe in, which is a widely available, safe, affordable, and reversible male contraceptive. We want to thank MCI for their contribution to what we're doing, because it allows us to make progress, and it allows us to make progress at a rate where we can ultimately be successful. You know, the world doesn't stand still as time passes, and the ability to get going on the studies that we need to conduct in order to get to our first in man use is extremely important to us, and it's important to our success.